Welcome back to Dark Souls 3. I'm going to go explore the swamp some more in a couple minutes, but before that, I want to go into some detail on something that I've just realized. So, you know how you can infuse weapons with different gems, like heavy, sharp, refined, raw, fire? Well, I've just taken a look at all these different gems, and I just came to the realization that there's actually some impressive subtleties to how all these different gems work. And now I finally get what their purposes are. And the stats in Dark Souls 1, 2, and 3 are something that I've always found very obtuse and confusing, and hard to understand. And I'm guessing you probably find it the same way, unless you've played this game a lot or looked at a bunch of wikis. So let me break this down to explain exactly what's going on with these different gems. Okay, so weapons have scaling. I'm going to switch to the mouse here, by the way, so I can point to different things, because there's a million stats on the screen. Yeah, so weapons have different scaling with different stats. So for my S-Stock currently, this D means it has a D scaling in strength. The C means it has a C scaling in dexterity. And then these are for, I think, intelligence and faith, which are for spellcasters. And that determines how much damage you gain from that stat increasing. So, if I had an A in strength, then it would scale very well with strength, and if I got a higher strength, it would do significantly more damage when my strength went up. You can see right now I have I've got a D in strength, a C in dexterity, so it's going to scale a bit better with dexterity, which makes sense because the S-Stock is made for a dexterity kind of build. You know, it's not a heavy weapon. So that's how weapon scaling works, and the damage that the scaling contributes to your weapon is the plus next to it. So this 136 is the base damage. That's the base damage of the S-Stock itself, plus the plus 3 from the Titanite shards and stuff. That all goes into the base damage. And then the plus 25 here is the scaling that's being contributed to the damage through the strength and dexterity bonus on it. So what these different gems do is you want to use the different gems depending on what kind of a character build you're going for. So the raw gem, as you can see here, the stat on the left is what my S-Stock currently has. The thing on the right is what it will get if I infuse it with raw. As you can see, the scaling actually goes away. It no longer scales with dexterity or strength. Which makes sense because the name of it is raw. And what happens with the damage is that the base damage goes up, but there's no longer any plus because it doesn't scale with anything, which means this weapon is never going to get any better based on your strength or dexterity. It'll only get better if you use more Titanite shards and Titanite chunks on it. So it might be a short-term gain in damage, possibly, but in the long term, if you're going to dump any points into strength or dexterity, it's a bad idea. And then there's the refined, sharp, and heavy. So these depend on how you want to allocate the strength versus dexterity. Refined just gives you a straight across, kind of balanced, a balance between strength and dexterity. It makes it so it scales the same level with both strength and dexterity. So if you're that kind of a balanced build, then this might be the sort of weapon you'd want. But you do pay something for it. If you notice, the base damage goes down. So it might scale better, but the base damage is less. So you'd only want refined if you actually have a significant amount of points in strength and dexterity. And sharp focuses on dexterity. So the dexterity now scales with B instead of C, so it scales better with dexterity, but worse with strength. And then heavy is the same sort of thing, except it makes it so it scales better with strength, and less good with dexterity. So there's actually a lot of subtlety here in which sort of a build you're going for. It's actually really impressive. I never paid much attention to it, but I've gone ahead and run the numbers, and it was a toss-up between refined gem and sharp gem, because right now my character build is fairly even in dexterity and strength. And it looks like if I go with a refined gem, which is the balanced between dexterity and strength, I will have a net gain of 2 damage. And if I go with the sharp gem, I'll have a net gain of 5 damage. So sharp gem is the way to go for that reason. Plus, it's also the way to go because I do intend to put more points into dexterity, but probably won't put any more points into strength. Because the only reason I put 16 points into strength in the first place is so I could end up using the halberd. So I'm probably not going to put much, if anything, into strength ever again. So I'm going to go ahead and infuse my S-Stock with sharp. There we go. Now we have a sharp S-Stock. And also, just for fun, because I don't use the halberd very much, I want to infuse it with fire. Just to see what happens. Looks like I'm missing some souls, though. Ah, I'm 60 souls short. Let's go ahead and pop one.
It wasn't neat.
Flaming halberd. I wonder if that makes it so it burns passively with like a cool visual effect. Let's see. Oh, it doesn't. Well, I'm sure I'll see the fire damage when I hit an enemy. Also, something I need to do, which I almost forgot, is I believe I have something to increase my Estus, right? Yes. Do I have any more? No.
Pretty, be careful.
Okay, so I think I just gained another Estus slot. Yeah, 7 Estuses. Sweet. Back to the swamp. So many summon signs. Deep star 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 hole. Do I want to summon the mad phantom deep asshole? Nah, I'm good. No thanks. Alright, I've been to the right, I've been to the left. Let's go towards the center, I guess. Ow. Let's try this out. I want to see it burn. I keep dodging too early. Yeah, burn! Long wind up on that AoE. That wasn't worth it. Jesus Christ, okay. Danger, danger, danger! Oh, I just used my binoculars. Stop poking me! I'm gonna backstab you. Or not. I'll backstab you. Now, I don't want to kill those adorable little crabs, but there is a big crab that's moving really fast! I think it sees me! Hi. Let's see if it'll follow me up to land. That thing can move! I wonder if it's like a mini-boss. Okay, looks like it won't follow me too far. The swamp is its home and it doesn't want to leave. What did you- You just killed one of your babies! No! Alright. Let's go for it. Ooh, weak point. Underneath. Uh-oh, I've been invaded. Also, I'm covered in soapy bubbles. Where are you? There you are. Hi. Hello? Perfectly synced. Oh, they slow roll. All right, they've got really heavy armor on. Oh, nice. I think they had a flame burge as a weapon. That kind of serrated blade thing. Good for killing people and cutting bread. Not too early again. Babies! Stop killing your babies! It's super vulnerable when it goes to spit on me. Come on, spit on me. Come on. Keep killing your babies! Stop! Oh my God, yes! Maybe the babies won't attack me now? I don't know if it's going away from me or if it's just confused. You won't attack me now, right? No! What? Maybe it just wanted a hug, actually. I'll hug you. Come here. Ow. Look. Can't we just talk about this? I'm tired. I'm tired of fighting. Oh, fine. Bullies. I want to take a look at that ring once I'm somewhere safe. Eh, we got like 5 minutes before those slowpokes can catch up with me. There we go. I went past it, didn't I? This one boosts pyromancies. Ugh, not useful for me. Rings, I'm about to be attacked. Oh God, there's another one. Ring said to be chiseled from the bone of a flame salamander by blinded pyromancers living in the Great Swamp. It is believed that salamanders are the descendants of demons born of the Chaos Flame, from which pyromancy is also said to have originated. I remember the flame salamanders from Dark Souls 2. Those things were really annoying. Let's see if the other crab has another ring or something. See if it can smell me coming. Nope. Can I backstab the crab? Oh no, oh no, please don't kill me. I'm dead, aren't I? Damn it. I saw its mouth frothing up. I thought it was gonna spit on me, but then it grabbed me. See if this way is a little bit safer. Skip some of the zombies. Whoa, something awakened? No, good. I thought maybe one of those demonic grave monsters was coming after me. Oh god. Don't die. Don't die. Haven't got my souls back yet. Please don't die. These things are so annoying to deal with. One on one, they're so easy, but two or three. Please let me get my souls! Fuck! Nah, it's fine. I only had like 2,000 or 3,000 souls, it's not that big of a deal. I could've just walked there without it seeing me. I just ran because I thought I'd be fine. I don't even care anymore. I hate you, assholes. Okay, nice and easy. Oh no, the other crab's back. Oh! Okay! You know, fine. I'll fight you here. I don't need my souls back. There's not that many there anyway. No! Don't join the party! Not fair! Get out of here! Oh, don't... Its health just regenerated, didn't it? It did. I saw it go up to max right before it disappeared. Fine. Confused again. Look at them go. Don't know what to do with themselves. Now, does the other one come back or what? I might have to respawn here to make it come back, actually. Oh, wait, no, there it is. No drop. For some reason, I can only slow walk here. This is as fast as I can go. Is it because it's deeper water or something? Yeah, it's deep water. Deep water, you can only walk and slow roll. Okay, worth keeping in mind. So I've already been over there. Great Swamp Pyromancy Tome. Oh, I can give that to the sorcerer guy, right? Full set of gear. Go this way in just a second. I want to see what that armor looks like. Of course I'm not going to use it because it's way too light. Was it conjurer or sorcerer? I think it was conjurer. No! Oh, hey. Are these like siblings or something? A duo? Well, I've got no more pots left. Oh, these bastards are gonna be tough. They've got that, like, super sort of smart faux real player AI. Where they kind of move randomly, sort of, going left and right, and they dodge a lot. Alright, see if I can get over there without attracting too much. I don't think the crabs will follow me on land, so I think I can just run. Run through the center of the swamp. Yeah, okay. Right, so as I was about to do before they rudely interrupted me... I think it was Conjurer? Interesting. Let's try the pants on. Definitely not the most fancy looking. Pretty basic. Wait, this isn't what I was using. No, I was using these. Where's the other one? Are they hiding? There they are, they're back there. Oh, maybe you don't have to fight two at the same time. Maybe I was just unlucky to get both of them. Oh no! The other one has eyes, damn. I'm gonna hit. Oh no. No! I'm alive! Crab, get him! Got one. Alright, we're good now. I can take on one, no problem. Oh, maybe not! Oh, thank God. It missed. Great sword, thanks. I don't think so. No healing here. Dropped both their weapons. It was Exile Greatsword, right? That thing does a massive amount of damage. Base damage is 146. 24 strength. bloodstained greatsword wielded by one of the watchdogs of Farron, who presided over the slumber of fallen warriors. The blade is a reminder of the exile's past misdeeds. Inhuman strength is required to wield this heaviest of curved greatswords. And what was the other one? It was a club, right? But which club? Great club or large club? Either way, the description doesn't look interesting. Hint ahead. What's the hint? Turn back. No. How do you get up there? I don't see anywhere to fall down onto it. Oh wait, that's a pathway up there, isn't it? Right above those rocks. Yeah, that's a pathway. Oh! Yeah, we can actually go there right now. That's the pathway that I never actually ended up going through over here. Golden Falcon Shield. That sounds cool. Metal shield fashioned in the form of a falcon with wings outstretched. The Golden Falcon was the emblem of an ancient band of sellswords, and even to this day, many mercenaries remain who look upon it as a token of good fortune. That looks highly impractical, but very beautiful. This is to protect my crotch. Never know, there might be a stray archer somewhere. Tricks, treats, secrets, traps. That's a long ladder. Bonfire ahead. Oh. Go get that bonfire. I hear bad things. Liar head. Probably talking about someone saying, "This is a wall you can go through." Never is. Never is. Poison ahead. Doesn't surprise me. This place looks nasty. Pulsating worms over there. Ugh. Before I get dirty in the muck, though, I want to know what's up here and down the stairs. Probably have to get up here from the swamp floor, I'm guessing. You know, I wonder if I could, like... I think there might be an invisible wall. Alright, forget it. Extinguish three flames and open the door to wolf's blood. Extinguish three flames. One, two, three. There's the three flames. Now what do? Shoot poison. Oh, I get poisoned just by standing in the swamp. Okay. So I'm gonna have to go from safety to safety. I can't stay too long in one place. So how does it compare? Surprisingly good protection against magic fire and all that stuff. And very good curse protection, but terrible everything else. Why is it so good at preventing curses? Likely a makeshift item that helped reduce intake of various poisonous and noxious fumes. Stylish. Can I find, like, a hazmat suit? Put this out. Well, how I interact with almost everything in this game is by stabbing it. Can I stab the fire out? No. Do I have anything throwable? Like throwable water or something. Maybe I can get them to spit the acid stuff at me when I'm standing in front of the flame? Come on. Come on. Oh my god, it's so slow. Close. coating it pretty good. Keep going. I don't think that works. It's kind of a clever idea, though. But it really doesn't work. Nah. Well, you know what? I don't think I want to put out the fires just yet anyway until I've explored this place further. It says it opens a door. I haven't even seen the door yet, so why bother trying to open it? Whew! That was close. I really wish my poison went down faster. Is there anything I can wear that has, like, really, really good poison protection? Let's see. Poison. Anything? This is the only thing that's better at protecting me against poison, and it's only better by 2 stat points. Nah. Poison. No, that's significantly better. 63, 68? Okay, worker's garb is pretty good. Let's try worker's garb. Do I have, like, worker's gloves? Yep, is that better at poison? It is. Okay, I'm gonna try putting on a full set of worker's stuff. Worker trousers. Yep, better at poison. Worker's hat. Let me guess, that was the one. Yep, that's the one that's better at poison. Right, because the worker's garb is meant for people who handle the dead. Makes sense. Now I look absolutely hideous and I have terrible armor, but let's see how well that does. Is that any better? That doesn't feel any better at all. Eh, whatever. I'll roll with it for a while. I'm assuming the fire burns me. Yeah, the fire burns me. Wait a minute, there's more than 3 fires. There's 4. Oh, but that fire over there that I saw, that's not like a ritual fire. The ritual fire are the ones happening around those totem poles and the large tree branch with a thing hanging from it. Those are some other fires. Estus Shard, yes! I don't think it's even worth killing those things. They give you so little of anything. They're just nuisances. So I can go up and around. Prism Stone. Strange that they give me so many. Almost like they're suggesting I use them. It's a thick swamp. Can't even see what's in there except for more of those leech things. It looks like it's gonna fall. It looks like a trap. I'm gonna try shooting it. It hit an invisible wall. Okay, it's nothing. Just ambience. I know there's gotta be so many collectibles just hidden behind these trees. I can feel it. Stay here so I don't get poisoned. It's not very effective. Oh my god, that was close. Is there, like, something I can take that just, like, increases my poison resistance by a crap ton? This only gets rid of poison that I already have. Bleeding. I don't think so. I don't have any watery things that I can see. I'm going for that shiny. Uh-oh. This is a very small patch in which to fight. Oh, that's a shield. Not easily stunned. That's very fast. Oh. Cracked red eye orb, why does that not surprise me? It's an item for PvP, I believe. Yep, consumed to invade another world. An appropriate item from quite a dick. There's gotta be secrets back here. I saw one. You know, I'm just gonna get poisoned. I'm gonna get poisoned, it's fine. I'm gonna collect all the shinies. That was a stone something, I wanna check that out in a second. I want to check around all the trees, because I know there's stuff hidden behind them. Could even be secrets over here. Behind doorways, or behind these walls and stuff. Be a devious place to hide them. Okay, I think that's it. Coal to give the smith. Ah, right, and I wanted to look at the description for that other item. What was it? I'm really not sure what it was. Maybe it was an undead hunter charm? I don't know. Maybe I shouldn't have taken the poison stuff. Wait, is this solid ground? No, that's not. Kinda look like it, but it's not! No! Oh, I'm so getting poisoned. Alright, fine. Actually, it's really not fine, because I don't have a way to cure it, and also I only have one Estus. So look for secrets before I perish. That pathway leads up. There is a nasty thing there. Really, really nasty thing. Don't want to touch that. I don't think I'm going to find a bonfire before I die. I think I'm going to have to homeward bone back to save my souls. Unless there's a bonfire up here, by any chance. This looks bonfireable. Nope, that's an enemy. Don't. No, fuck! That wasn't too bad. This one resting. That's a fire, but that is not a bonfire. Okay, you know what? I'm getting poisoned. I'm out of Estus. I don't think there's a bonfire nearby. I'm gonna homeward bone. I should really put homeward bone in my quick slot. It's not on there, is it? No. It really should be there. What shall I put it to? Dexterity is always good. Yeah, that'll increase my weapon damage by 3. Decent amount. Yeah, let's put it into dexterity. And let's go give the coal. Wait, I also got an Estus shard. Does that go here or does that go to the smith? Okay, smith. Now I've got 8 Estus. Nice.
Well, well. What's the Undead Legion doing with a coal such as this? I'd heard one of the Crystal Sages had sided with Farron's Abyss Watchers. I suppose it must be true. You should know. This coal is imbued with magic. First one I've ever seen. Hardly a surprise, is it? I've never been one for books or wise men. Pretty, be careful.
I think I have a pyromancy tomb for you, possibly.
Oh, you're back then. Again. I'm Orbeck of Vinheim, here to teach you sorceries. Let us begin with the basics. The ideal sorcerer bears the twin faces of the dragon. Oh, you could at least act as if you're paying attention.
Learn sorceries. Is there a sorcery to throw water? Nope.
I don't mean to seem overbearing, but have you forgotten? In exchange for my sorceries, you are to bring me knowledge in the form of scroll detailing the secrets of sorcery. I hope you're not one to break a promise.
I guess my pyromancy tome is... Well, I guess pyromancy is not the same thing as sorcery.
I don't mean to send in the form... I hope... Come again.
Do I have a pyromancer with me? I don't think so. Let me try speaking with this person over here. I don't think they're a pyromancer. But I do want to speak with them anyway, because perhaps they can give me another find your true strength kind of thing.
Oh, I would do any.
Yeah, it looks like I can draw true strength again. It still creeps me out that I can keep doing this.
Then
it worries me.
Begin, bearer.
I must be losing something by doing this. It just doesn't seem right. Alright, dexterity is good. Endurance is always good. More stamina is nice. Yeah, let's go with more stamina.
Be safe.
Okay, I guess I don't have anyone to give the pyromancy tomb to yet. Or tome, rather. Pyromancy tomb is much less pleasant than a pyromancy tome. Alright, so I hope you've enjoyed so far. And when I return, I'm gonna go back to exploring the poisonous swamp.